and I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We have a couple of confident teams coming into today's game. Both walked off the field with victories last time out. It's the Seahawks going up against the Rams.
All right, Larry, EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. The City of Angels showing it can be loud and raucous. This was the scene a moment ago as the home squad emerged from the tunnel. They're ready for football and ready to watch their Rams do battle with the Seattle Seahawks. The first quarter of the season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in Week 5 on EA Sports. It's a short kick here, fielded at the 24. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. Here on first down, and his first pass is incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact just as he's trying to haul it in.
This is the rookie from Oklahoma, Samaje Perine. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. Second down, a little more productive than first. 7 yards on the gain. It gets him to third and three now. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Again, here's Perine, and he brings this up to the 46, good enough for the first. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains. Didn't get it by much, but bottom line, got the first down, avoiding that three and out. How vital is that on the first drive?
To me, it's like the first round of a boxing match. You know, it may not mean much right then and there, but you'd rather not lose it, right? So you want to go ahead and get it, kind of establish something early, and hope it can carry through.
Josh Doxson's got it complete, and he's brought down. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. And early on, they're picking up right where they left off last week.
And I know a lot of coaches say each game is its own. You don't really have carryover. This feels like carryover. So much confidence from the previous game that they're using to their advantage now.
Ohio, here we go. What? Nine. Ohio, here we go. What? Nine.
Here's the first carry now for Todd Gurley. And after the good game last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
Tight end right. Come on, let's go.
Here's Watson now on second down. A quick hitter complete. It's Reynolds. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. They need to get to the 29 if they want to pick up a first here on third down.
Let's go!
He may try and run for this. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. A really nice effort that time. 12 yards on the keeper, picking up the first. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down.
Let's go! Five, nine,
here's Watson. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Now let's see who this is on. A little too aggressive defensively, and the flag comes out.
And no one trying to cover is going to like a call going against them, but you have to like the effort there. Went for the interception, just unable to get it, and the flag did come out.
First down and goal to go from the 7. Now P. Ryan. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line.
K.J. Wright just keeps getting better at outside linebacker. Long, lengthy guy, can rush the passer, can drop into coverage. Has great agility, though, to stay on his feet and make tackles, too.
And still has years ahead of him. Turned 27 in July. Native of Olive Branch, Mississippi. Now receiver in motion left. They'll run again with Piran. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the 1. Give him right around 4 on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on 3rd and goal. Contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? So the pigskin will move from the 2 down to the 1.
And I have not met an offensive line yet that doesn't think they can get it in from the 1-yard line on a running play.
9th play now, this long opening drive. Can they cash it in on 3rd and goal? They'll go to P-Line, trying to pound it in. And he takes it across for a Rams touchdown. A great effort there. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Rams are going to take a first quarter lead. It's up, it's good, and the Rams take a 7-0 lead. Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. On the return, the All-Pro 2 years ago, Tyler Lockett. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Time with Lacey. And he powers his way up past the 30. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks. He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week on the ground, they want to see in this game as well.
And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up 2nd and 5. And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here. Now the former Notre Damer, this is C.J. Procise. Takes to midfield, but no further, just a yard there.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Lacey gets the handoff from Wilson. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
They tried to run right into the teeth of the defense on third down, but looked like those teeth were pretty sharp.
They were having absolutely none of it. Stuffed them for a loss.
Yeah, couldn't get any leverage up front and move people aside in order to run the ball.
The Rams offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. Now they'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say when you run in the big-time races. It means they get out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now.
Very tough spot here for the offense to start. They start on the ground with Piron, and a short pickup here as he'll get across the 10 to the 11-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it, because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
So the offense looking at a second and 8. The gun, Watson. Jackson with a grab over the middle. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Gun. Here's Watson. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. He was looking for Cooper Kupp there, and that'll bring up second down.
One thing I have learned, receivers don't mind high throws so much to the sideline, but do that over the middle to them, and not only are the DBs going to throw a little verbal trash their way, when they get back to the huddle, they're going to have a few words to say to their QB, aren't they?
Yeah, hung out to dry a little bit there on the high throw. Luckily, fell incomplete. Second down now after the incompletion.
Come on, let's go! Ohio! Here we go! Ohio!
Here's Piron. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10. Big boys down there in the trenches, and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you talk about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
The Rams on third down, a perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and 10. Back to throw, Watson. And they'll set up the screen to Gurley. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. 5 yards on the screen, but that'll take us to fourth down.
They dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a first down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this punt sails over the sideline, and the spot, it looks to be right at the 25-yard line. And coming up later tonight in the NFL, we'll have the Chiefs heading down to Houston to take on the Texans. And then on Monday night, it'll be an NFC North battle. Vikings and Bears from Soldier Field.
Traditional rivals getting after it one more time.
They start the drive on the ground with Lacey. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs. First down carry, it's Lacy. And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
Again, it's Lacy. And he's going to be stopped dead in his tracks. Right there around the 35-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for a first. Now Wilson. And he fires one but incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
And he's going to miss this one. Wide to the left from distance. It's no good, and this score will stay right where it is. So an empty possession there. What do you think went wrong, Charles?
Well, it looked like maybe the plant leg might have given way just a little. And when that happens, guys have a tendency to pull through the ball to compensate. And in doing so, set this one off target.
Now a play fake here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. And he slides to avoid the hit. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
On first down, Watson. And that'll be incomplete.
When we talk with people about what we think the most important quality for an NFL quarterback to possess, what do people usually say?
Arm strength. He showed the arm strength there.
Yeah, pretty good bullet pass he threw, but he wasn't accurate, was he?
No.
Listen, you like mobility, but accuracy, first and foremost, is what a quarterback needs. He didn't possess it on that play.
Carry for Piron. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
If you love old-school running backs, I think you're going to really like Samaje Perine. Strong, built low to the ground, great leverage when he runs the football, and bodies just scatter. He's hard to get on the ground.
Back to the ground, this time with Gurley. He's to the 10, and able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. Last year, Gurley, 74% of LA's carries. That's the highest percentage in the league.
But no real payoff, because they finished 31st in the league in rushing. I think as a team, they ran for 78 yards per game. They had a 1,000-yard receiver.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. Bobby Wagner. In from his linebacker spot, he's able to drop him for a loss of about 10. Second down, here's Watson. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach.
Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down.
Now we got third and goal coming up, and couldn't you imagine being in that huddle, partner? You know they're looking at each other saying, we can't come away with just 3 points after this drive.
Yeah, they've covered a lot of ground. They want more than that three. Third and long, it's Watson. Now he'll escape to his right. He's going to run, but he's got a long way to go. The scramble good for a nice gain of 10 yards, but still fourth down.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
So give them three there. A good drive gets them inside the five, but they couldn't punch it in.
And credit this defense, too. That was the old bend but don't break approach, but it kept the offense out of the end zone.
Tyler Lockett now with a return. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer
Closer.
Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Officially a minute 54 to go in this first half. We're back to the City of Angels after this timeout. Fresh set of downs here. They'll run. This is Lacy. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. And now the Rams are going to halt things as they want a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. On second down, Wilson. And he fires one incomplete. Tyler Lockett was the target there, and it's third down.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
On third down, Wilson. And this is going to be incomplete.
Boy, you will not see a quarterback of his caliber miss on one like that very often. I mean, there it is, wide open, got the shot, and he misfired.
We talk about, boy, he'll want that one back all the time. He definitely wants that one back. So this offensive unit, they've now had three drives, and they only have 3 points to show for it.
Payoff is the key for everything. How many offenses have we talked to that say we have to finish drives? Thus far, this team hasn't finished it quite the way they wanted to.
And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe-mashed.
Super toe.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Todd Gurley, his second touchdown on the season. And the Rams strike quickly here for 6 points. It's up and good, and that makes it 17-3. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march onto the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. They run it again with Lacy. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
Wow, that play got shut down in a hurry.
As soon as the snap came, you can see defensively they were just closing in. That was going nowhere.
Yeah, you count on your offensive line.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Dominique Rogers-Cromartie. And they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line. Interception. Here's Watson. Wide open receiver complete and brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. 15 yards through the air and a 1st down.
Here we go.
They'll run it here with Piron. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Give him 11 yards and time and a new set of downs.
Love the run right there. And when you analyzed him coming out of college, when you tried to put a grade on him, you saw the flashes while he was in school, but you didn't see the full production. You didn't see the finished product. He's a little bit raw, but you can see why people liked him. Those types of runs make you think there's plenty more there, and we'll see if that continues for him.
Watson. So we come upon halftime here in Southern California with the Rams on top as we send you cross country to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando with our halftime report. Here's Larry Ridley. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to come back onto the field. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the 2nd half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this is
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the 2nd half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Now we're going to get a timeout here as it looks like there's a Seahawk injured on the play. We'll check on his status when we get back. 3 yards to go on 2nd down. Precise on the toss. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. He lost 2 there, and it's 3rd down.
If these guys are going to chop into that deficit, they got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage would be found.
The Seahawks on 3rd down. Not good. 0 for 4 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. Here's Wilson to throw. And able to find Graham. Complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. And that goes as a gain of 37 on 3rd down.
As we continue to advance in the NFL, as people continue to scout players, they really don't care as much about body types as they care about those guys who can make people miss, run through tackles, and gain all that additional run after catch. Anybody who has that ability, they want them on their team.
They'll throw on 1st down with Wilson. This will be caught inside the 10. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. 23 yards on the play. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Wilson. He rifles one that's intercepted. It's the rookie from Boston College, John Johnson. And he'll go down inside the 15 at his own 13-yard line. First possession in the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
It's Pirine to begin the drive. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs.
Come on, let's go! White, nine, cut.
Now it's Watson. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it, or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. Second down following the incompletion.
Here we go. White, nine. Black round. Black round. Cut.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Calling no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is, and really a lot of the time they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance, they're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Watson now to throw. A deep ball for Dotson. And that one incomplete. Had some position, but couldn't hold on, and it brings up fourth down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play, and guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they've managed to get it done.
Here come the Seahawks now, set to take over on offense. And they had a nice little drive going last time. Threw the interception in the red zone, costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it?
I'd say it's pretty good strategy. If you throw interceptions on back-to-back drives, let's see if the running backs can handle the ball a little bit, get things going. And also, you motivate your offensive line. I think they're in the mood to fire out and hit someone.
I thought the defense, though, might be a little more prepared for that run. Pretty good gain on the ground. A second down carry for ProSize. And down he'll go at the 25. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give them a new set of downs.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
On first down, again, they go ProSize. And now they're going to get him down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Well, at least he was able to break that initial contact, or it could have been a loss.
Yeah, give credit to the defensive player, though. What did he do? Made him slow down, slow up his feet, and allowed the rest of the guys to get there to finish him off.
Now Lacy, even with that broken tackle, can't go very far. Stops short of the 30. It's a gain of about 3, but it's going to leave him with third and still 7 yards to go. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down. Off the fake to Lacy, here's Wilson. And he's got Lockett. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. On first down, Wilson. And Lockett with a grab over the middle. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Here's Wilson, and it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. And that's complete to Luke Wilson. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. One Wilson to another for a Seahawk first down.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
On first and 10, it's Wilson. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Duke Riley in there to drop him, and that will go into the books as the first sack of his young NFL career. Now Wilson on second down. End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. Luke Wilson, his second touchdown on the season. And the Seahawks able to make this a close game again. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
This will be fielded at the 8. Oh, now he bowls him over. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. The Rams offense now making their way out to take over. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Black Brown! Black Brown! Cut!
They go play action here on first down. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete.
Ohio! Ohio! Black Brown!
Here we go!
Red 38!
And again, this time to the tailback. Across the 30 to the 31-yard line. Call it about a gain of 3, and they'll be looking at a 3rd and 7 coming up.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
The Rams on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is 3rd and 7. Now Watson. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. Here comes the Rams punter now, as he'll come on to kick this one away. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And this one's out of bounds. Should be inside the 10, I think it is, at the 6-yard line. And Seattle now ready to march out of the field. The lone second remains now in this third quarter. Now Wilson on first down. It's complete to Lockett. And he's out of bounds, but not before a big pickup that time on what's going to wind up being the final play of the third quarter. On first down. And Graham's got it over the middle. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. A really good pickup of 28 yards. They'll run. This is Lacy. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Let's see what the offense comes with here. Second and eight. On the ground, this is Lacy. And very little there. He might have gotten a yard. Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
On third down, here's Lacy. And he'll take this one down to about the 40. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
When the 4-3 defense is functioning really well, you know who stays what we call clean and no one gets to him? The guy playing the middle linebacker position, the guy we call Mike. That means the defensive front has eaten up all the blocks and just let him go to the football and make a play.
And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. So an interesting call there to take the three. I guess they're thinking their hands were tied, but in the fourth quarter, that field goal, it really might not help them much at all.
Yeah, I mean, you still need a touchdown. Another field goal does you no good, so it'll be interesting to see what the media reaction is if the score stays where it is.
And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now with a game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
And a nice carry there of 15 yards. Give it here to his running back. And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here.
Come on, let's go!
To throw on second is Watson. He's going to get this one out to his fullback. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving. Well, probably the only thing he did wrong there was go out of bounds, nursing this fourth quarter lead. You want to stay in, eat the clock.
Yeah, you got to love the effort, the catch, the extra yardage, but you got to know the situation. Stay in bounds, young man.
On first down, it's Watson. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And nothing doing here as this time the run maybe gets them back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up. The Rams on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This is third and 16. Out of the gun, Watson. And this one is incomplete.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
They've gone to the fourth quarter now in Dallas, and the Cowboys on the board again. It's a 2-touchdown lead there. A win would be their second on the young season. The Seattle now ready to march onto the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they've got to make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see.
If you're the coaching staff upstairs, you might want to file that play away. Did you see how fast the safety closed on that one? Coming up in run support, made a big-time tackle. Might want to try and check into a pass next time.
Yeah, got him for a loss. Really, really great play defensively. Time running out here on the play clock. There's Wilson. He hits Baldwin right side. And they're going to get this one up past the 25. A good pickup there, a 22. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me.
And oh, he caught it up, and now the Rams have got it going the other way. Let's see now, Charles, that's 7 turnovers between last week and this week. 3 here in this game, 4 in last week's game.
You know I do my research, right? And I go all the way back to the best coaches that have ever been in this game. And all of them started with ball security in some form or another, understanding that taking care of the ball was the key to winning games. They can't believe what they're seeing right now because they spend all the...
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off with great anticipation. And he's going to score. It's a Seahawk touchdown. This game, it's been defensively oriented on both sides, so I guess it stands to reason that the play of the game comes on defense.
So it's my kind of game. You know that.
That's
anytime
right.
We have
that's
a defensive
right.
battle. But that, as you said, it stands to reason that's the way the game tilted. Someone had to make a big play, and the way the defenses were dominating, that's exactly what we got.
So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That'll be taken in the end zone. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. So now here are the Rams as their offense comes back out. And last time, decent field position through the pick 6. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much, Austin.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
Back to throw. And some room to work. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it'll make it 2nd down. Watson trying to get his guys moving.
Here we go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Back to throw. Flushed out right. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know, in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movements. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to do what we call flatliner. Level.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. So a collective holding a breath here as the starter heads for the sideline. And they'll turn things over here to the backup to see if he can dig him out of this hole. They'll run it now out of the gun. Room to run past midfield. And finally brought down right at the midfield stripe. It'll be a gain of 11. And that'll bring up a third down.
That's exactly what they were looking for. If they get another gain like that, they'll be right there in field goal range.
And the tension building. And nearly intercepted there. That would have been ball game if he had clinched it and caught it. Instead, it gives him one more chance here on fourth down. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Try it here. He's back to throw. It's complete on the bubble screen. That's Reynolds. Give him 13 on the pickup there. And it'll be first down Rams. One crisis averted, but they still need to move hastily. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. It'll be a pickup of 5 on the keeper. It's second down. And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So second and medium, second and 5 now. They'll run it now out of the gun. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage.
I know they got a little yardage there, but I'm not sure their investment is right. They're still running the football, and I'm not sure there's enough time to continue to do that.
The Rams on third down. They've converted a third of their opportunities, 3 for 9. This is 3rd and 7. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. Now the defense will burn their 3rd and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. And again, this time to the tailback. And he's going to get this one down inside the 15. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 2.
We can't be totally sure that that was by design, but we do know that a lot of kickers like the ball in the right hash in order to kick the field goal.
And it is good! He splits the uprights on the chip shot, and the Rams have won the game! Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
So for Los Angeles, they improved to 5-0 now on the young season. And they will hit the road next week for a date with the Jacksonville Jaguars. Meanwhile, for the Seahawks, The loss will move them back to 3-2 on the year. And perhaps fortunately for them, they'll get an early bye next week and come back to action in week 7. So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Rams are victorious here as we say so long from Exposition Park in L.A.